IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 has lots of new features, improvements, and bug fixes. IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 introduces a new way of running our applications. Usually, when we run an application from inside the IDE, it runs it locally with all the settings from the IDE. Now, we can edit the run configuration of an application or test to set a run target. For example, we could run this Spring Boot application with an SSH or Docker target. If we choose Docker, we can choose to build or pull an image. And if we pull an image, we get code completion helping us to select the correct image. I'm going to try running this on JDK 16 as it's just about to be released and I want to see if my application will still run on it. IntelliJ IDEA will locate what it needs, either locally or by downloading the resources. IntelliJ IDEA will select a sensible default configuration, and you can change these settings if you need to. Once the configuration is set up, when we run this application, it will run on the target we selected. In our case, using the OpenJDK 16 Docker image. We can configure a run target of Docker, SSH or WSL for Java unit tests, Maven and Gradle projects, and for Spring Boot, Micronaut and Quarkus applications. This feature is actively being developed, so please give us feedback on how you use it or want to use it. IntelliJ IDEA continues to provide useful features for us regardless of our version of Java. In IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1, we can now select an inspection profile for running analysis before we commit. If we don't analyze our code before we commit, we can end up committing changes that don't compile, or have other critical errors and not be aware of it. Let me just roll back that change and try this again. This time, when I commit, I can select a profile to use to analyze the code. This way, we can create an inspection profile with a much smaller number of checks. For example, only Java errors and warnings. It can run much faster than our full inspection profile and prevent us from committing breaking changes. We can create inspection profiles here in the settings or preferences. IntelliJ IDEA's data flow analysis can locate even more places where we could have errors in our code. For example, if we use a negative number for initializing an array, or checking for negative values where the value couldn't be negative. Java developers aren't always working with just Java code, and it's nice when IntelliJ IDEA makes it easier to use other languages or formats too. IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 comes with a built-in preview for HTML, so we can get a good idea of what our changes will look like as we're making them. IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 also comes with support for JSON path expressions. We can open up a window to evaluate JSON path expressions by going to Edit, Find, Evaluate JSON path expression. If we have a JSON file open, it will use this file to evaluate the expression. We get code completion based on the values in the document. We can try out various search expressions and see what values are returned. If we have JSON path expressions as strings in our Java code, we can use inject language to tell IntelliJ IDEA this is a JSON path expression. Then we'll get code formatting and completion inside this string. We can evaluate this JSON path expression. This will open up the same window as we saw earlier, only this time we'll put our own snippet of JSON into the input window. This way, we can quickly try out if our expression finds the path we're expecting. IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 has full support for Java 16. We've seen some Java 16 features already, as there were preview features in Java 15 and 14. For example, records were available as a preview feature, but now they're a standard feature and can be used in production code. We can create a new record from the new Java class dialog. we type the name of the record and select the record type. Records define their components in the declaration. Then we don't need to have a constructor or accessor methods, and the record has a default implementation of equals, hashcode, and toString. We can refactor the records the same way we'd refactor any Java classes. For example, we can rearrange the order of the components or rename them. As usual, IntelliJ IDEA can help us migrate our existing code to use new language features. For example, IntelliJ IDEA can identify classes that are data holders and can be converted to records. This class has three fields which do not change value, a standard constructor, and getters. Records don't have accessors with a get prefix, so if we want to change a class like this to a record, we might want to first refactor the getter methods to remove the prefix. Then, when we convert this class to a record, the fields will become record components, and the constructor and accessors will be removed. If we're okay to use the default implementations of equals, hashcode, and toString on record, we can also remove these methods to create a succinct data class. We can safely experiment with different styles in our codebase, as IntelliJ IDEA can usually convert code to and from the new syntax. If we decide that this maybe should be a full Java class after all, we can get IntelliJ IDEA to automatically convert a record into a Java class. Remember that we can run an inspection over the whole codebase, so we can look for all the classes that could be records, instead of having to just do them one by one. Another Java feature that was a preview feature, but is now available as a standard feature in Java 16, is pattern matching for instance of. IntelliJ IDEA can find places in our code that do an instance of check followed by a cast, and replace this code with a new syntax which removes the need for the cast. There were some changes to this feature in Java 16, which are fully catered for in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1. Specifically, the pattern variable, in our case employee, was implicitly final, but now these variables can be modified if required. IntelliJ IDEA can find these cases too, and suggest using the new syntax. If we do need this variable to be final, we have to declare it as such. Java 16 introduced some new methods on the Streams API to help make common cases easier to use. In JDK 16, we don't have to use the collect method with a to unmodifiable list collector, and IntelliJ IDEA lets us know about this. The IDE can automatically convert the code to use the new toList method. This is a nice convenience for one of the most common use cases for streams. Java 16 also has preview features. Sealed classes is still in preview in JDK 16. As a reminder, if we want to try out preview features in IntelliJ IDEA, we need to change our language level to select preview. We may also need to update our Maven or Gradle file to allow this too. Sealed classes are a way to take control of the inheritance hierarchy of our classes. If we have a sealed class like this one, IntelliJ IDEA will tell us we need to permit the child class so it can extend this parent. It will automatically make changes if it can. IntelliJ IDEA can let us know about problems in the classes that extend sealed classes and suggest solutions for these too. Any other changes that have been introduced in Java 16 are fully supported in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1. For example, we can use local records, enums or interfaces, or static methods on inner classes. Polyglot JVM developers will be pleased to see that Kotlin support in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 continues to evolve, particularly in terms of providing features they're used to from Java being available in Kotlin. For example, Java developers have been able to define illegal package dependencies in their inspections, which can prevent code from accidentally depending upon the wrong packages, for example, the database layer depending upon the UI layer. This is now also available in Kotlin code, which is helpful not only for those with mixed Java and Kotlin codebases, so they can use the same inspection to enforce these rules, but also for pure Kotlin projects. JVM developers working with Kotlin code can also now benefit from UML diagrams for their Kotlin classes, just like they could do with Java classes. We saw language injection in Java strings a little earlier in this video. In IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1, we can expect even better language injection in Kotlin files. Previously, this worked for a single string value. Now, if the string is broken up and uses concatenation, we still get the code suggestions we expect for each section of the string. If you're writing Kotlin in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1, you should also notice that the syntax and error highlighting is faster in this version, and that code completion is also faster. IntelliJ IDEA has improved support for Windows Subsystem for Linux. IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 has support for Java projects in WSL2 and for Maven and Gradle. To find out more, visit these two pages on our blog. The profiler in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 has had a facelift and is easier to use. We can access the profiler window using Find Action or via the Quick Access buttons. It shows a list of running processes, and if we click on one, we can attach a profiler to the process. For example, a CPU profiler. When we've collected enough of a profile, we can show the results. Here we can see the results as a flame graph. If we click on the process, we can also edit the configurations of the profilers. For each type of profiler, we can define the settings we need. If we right-click on the process, we can capture a memory snapshot at this moment in time. We can then open this to see which objects are taking up the most space on the heap. Another option from the right-click menu is we can see the CPU and memory use in real time. This is really helpful for getting a current view on what's happening in our application right now. And if we make changes, for example, shutting down a service, we can see how that impacts the machine. Profiling is a powerful tool for visualizing the performance of an application or set of services, and IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 makes it easier to access this information. IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 has lots of other improvements throughout, including a huge number of bug fixes. You may notice some of the UI changes, like an improved color scheme for UML diagrams if you're using a light theme. This should make the diagrams easier to read. We can now also change the font weights for code. In Settings or Preferences, Editor, Font, we can choose a different weight for the main code and for the bolder sections of our code. We can use this to create a UI that most suits us when we're reading code. If you're using JetBrains' new team collaboration tool, Space, or thinking of using it, you'll be pleased to hear the Space plugin is now bundled in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 and provides you with key functionality for working within the IDE. We can use Get from VCS to get a project that's hosted in Space. We'll need to make sure we're logged into our team instance. And then from here, we can get code from the repositories in our projects. Of course, we can configure where this code is cloned to. The Space plugin does more than the one-off task of cloning our project. We can right-click on the Git log to open a commit in Space if we want to take a look at it there. The integration is really helpful for code reviews. We can open the Space Code Reviews tool window to see a list of reviews that need our attention. There are a number of preset searches here. Let's take a look at all the closed reviews so we can see what one looks like. We can see the review title, the authors and the reviewers. We can see the files that were changed. The editor shows the history of the review with the commits that were added, the changes to the review, any commit level comments, any line level comments, and the status of the discussions. I can make changes to the review here and reply to anything that needs my attention. Space code reviews are shaped like a series of conversations, so I can start threads on anything in the history or chat any of my thoughts. There's lots more to working with Space take a look in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1. In the release video for IntelliJ IDEA 2020.3, we gave a quick demo of JetBrain's new tool for collaborative development, Code With Me. This is now bundled in IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1 and has also had a huge number of improvements since the last video. Code With Me lets us invite someone to pair with us on our project on our machine. We can choose the permissions for the guests. We may want read-only if we're just showing something to someone. We may want full access for someone else on our team who we're pairing with. And we can customize these permissions. Code With Me now supports voice and video calls, making it much easier to work with your remote pair or mob. We can see the Code With Me controls in the navigation bar. I'm waiting for my guest to join my session. Helen has joined my session, and now I'm following her, I can see what she's doing. I could choose not to follow her, or force everyone to follow what I'm doing. I've enabled my mic and video, and I can open the call window to see who I'm speaking to. If we're pairing on code, we might only need voice chat to discuss what we're doing, but if we're explaining something to someone, it might be easier to do it with video. We can also use the chat window for keeping a record of notes or a conversation, or sending relevant info that's not in the code. The video window is just another tool window which can be opened, moved around, and closed as we need. You can see here that while I'm moving the IDE windows around, Helen is making changes to the code in my project. Code With Me is a very interesting way to collaborate on code, or even other types of work. You can see here Helen and I were using it to pair on writing a blog. Those were just some of the highlights of what Java developers can expect from working with IntelliJ IDEA 2021.1. As always, there's much more in the IDE, so take a look and have a go. Thanks for watching.